Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. So we are now on introduction to a problem solving under of lesson 1. So based on the mathematician, si George Pólya, the father of modern problem solving. George Pólya was born in Hungary in 1887. He received his Doctor of Philosophy at the University of Budapest in 1940. He came to Brown University and then joined the faculty at Stanford University in 1942. In his studies, he became interested in the process of discovery, which led to his famous four-step process for solving problems. Ito yung kanyang four-step process. Understand the problem, devise a plan, carry out the plan, and look back. Pólya wrote over 250 mathematical papers and 3 books that promote problem solving. So, ito yung cycle ng kanyang problem, four-step process ng kanyang problem solving. So, understanding the problem, devise a plan, carry out the plan, and look back. His most famous book entitled How to Solve It, which has been translated into 15 languages. Introduce his four-step approach together with the heuristics or strategies, which are helpful in solving problems. Other important works by Pólya are Mathematical Discovery, Volumes 1 and 2, and Mathematics and Plausible Reasoning, Volume 1 and 2. He died in 1985, leaving mathematics with the important legacy of teaching problem solving. Then, kay George Pólya, then meron siyang tinatawag na 10 commandments for teachers. So, ito yung kanyang mga 10 commandments. Be interested in your subject. Importante yung kay George Pólya. And second commandment niya ay know your subject. Third, kanya tinatawag na commandments, try to read the faces of your students. Try to see their expectations and difficulties. Put yourself in their place. And next commandment niya, I realize that the best way to learn anything is to discover it by yourself. And for number 5, give your students not only information, but also know-how, mental attitudes, the habit of methodical work. Okay, for number 6, let them learn guessing. For number 7, let them learn proving. And for number 8, look out for such features of the problem at hand as may be useful in solving the problems to come. Try to disclose the general pattern that lies behind the present concrete situation. And number 9, do not give away your whole secret at once. Let the students guess before you tell it. Let them find out by themselves as much as is feasible. And the last, number 10, suggest do not force information down their throats. Okay, so we have problem solving strategies according to George Pólya. We have 1 to 6, guess and test. Second strategy, draw a picture. Use a variable. Look for a pattern. Number 5, make a list. And number 6, solve a simpler problem. Because problem solving is the main goal of mathematics, this chapter introduces the 6 strategies listed in the problem solving strategies box that are helpful in solving problems. Then at the beginning of each chapter, an initial problem is posed that can be solved by using the strategies or strategy introduced in the chapter. As you move through this slide, the problem solving strategies boxes at the beginning of each chapter expand, and as should your ability to solve problems. Okay, sa tingnan natin itong initial problem. Ang instruction, place the whole numbers 1 through 9 in the circles in the accompanying triangle so that the sum of the numbers on each side is 17. Ito yung ano. Ibig sabihin, kailangan makomplete natin yung 1 to 9. Then, pag kinompute natin yung each side ng triangle, dapat ang maging sagot ay 17. Since ito ay naka-triangular form, ibig sabihin meron tayong 3 sides na kailangan ang sagot nila ay 1 to 17. I-fill out lang natin yung numbers 1 to 9. So, hindi pwede magkaroon ng repetition number. Okay. Okay, para sa ating initial problem, so place the whole numbers 1 through 9 in the circles in the accompanying triangle so that the sum of the numbers on each side is 17. So ang first attempt natin, nilagay natin yung mga first 3 numbers doon sa corner ng triangle 1, 2, and 3. Kahit anong rotation niya, no? Basta nandun yung 1, 2, and 3. Then kapag tingnan natin yung by side, meron na tayong 3 points at sa other side ay 5 points and 4 points. Next, yung matitirang other 2 circles sa bawat side, pwede natin kuhanin yung combination ng natitirang numbers or digit na ang total ay 12, 13, 14. Kasi doon sa 12, pag nilagay natin yun, pag kinuha natin yung 2, 3, and total 12, makukuha natin ang 17. At ang 12, ang pwede ay ang the sum of 8 and 4. Kaya pwede natin ilagay ang 8 and 4. Pwede naman siyang in any circle. Ganun pa rin naman yung total niya. No? So, 8 and 4. Yan. Kaya, yun ay sum of 12, then 2 and 3. So, 17 na tong side na to. Then dito naman sa second side ay meron ng 1 and 3 plus nilagay natin yung 13, makukuha din natin ng 17. Then sa combination, ang may total na 13 ay pwede ang 7 and 6. So ibig sabihin pwede natin ilagay ang 7 and 6. At ganun din, no? Kahit magpalit sila ng pwesto, okay lang kasi total pa rin naman ay 17. Okay? And yung 14 naman ay doon sa 1 and 2. At ang 14 ay 9 and 5 pwede. So 9 and 5 kahit sila yung magpalit, okay lang din. Makakuha pa rin tayo ng 14. So sa kabuuan, nakuha na natin ang total ng triangle kasi ang each side ay merong 17. So pag dinouble check natin, 1 plus 9 plus 5 plus 2, yon ang total nun ay 17. Then, pag yung next side ng triangle, 2 plus 8 plus 4 plus 3, yun din ay 17. At yung pinakalas or yung third side ng triangle, 1 plus 7 plus 6 plus 3, yun din ay 17. Okay, so nagawa natin yung sagot sa ating initial problem.